Hey friends, you've probably seen demos where an IoT sensor detects the failure of some system component. But what if you could detect an anomaly before it becomes a failure? Krishna from the Azure Big Data team is here to show us how to detect an anomaly in real time using machine learning functions in Azure Stream Analytics today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Krishna Mamidipaka from Azure Stream Analytics. How are you, sir?
I'm doing very well. Thank you, Scott.
I love it when people bring hardware. I just whatever you're going to do, it's going to be great because there's blinking lights happening.
Great. Awesome.
So this is a piece of hardware and you're going to show me how I can detect an anomaly with this, but it's not going to be very hard.
It's not going to be very hard. It's going to be very simple and very interesting.
Okay. So this data is being pushed into Azure Stream Analytics. I'm assuming that there's a world where I have millions of these, like a fleet of these, right?
Absolutely. Okay. That's how our customers do it, right? They have hundreds of these sensors that are attached to so many machines and components that they do not want to fail, and they want to detect early failures, early signs of failure. And that's where anomaly detection in real time really comes to play.
Mm-hmm. And this is all being put into Azure Stream Analytics?
Absolutely. Azure Stream Analytics is a fully managed PaaS service on Azure that helps you define your real-time analytics algorithms using very simple SQL-like language, and it is really cheap. You can get started at just about 11 cents per hour.
Seriously?
Yeah.
So even if I don't have millions of these, I could maybe just have a few dozen. I could set this up for my house.
Absolutely. A lot of our enthusiasts actually do that.
Really?
Yeah.
I like that. So here's a general overview of Azure Stream Analytics.
Yeah, so very easy to get started. We let you use a very simple SQL-like language. We let you integrate with about 15, 16 services on Azure with just a few configuration parameters. Absolutely no need to write any code. We stand by 3 nines of SLA and the enterprise readiness. Compliant with all kind of government and industry regulations and things like that.
Wow.
So it's a really easy system and solution for you to use and deploy and benefit from.
Okay, fantastic. Okay, so what is a HotPath?
HotPath analytics. So typically in analytics, you have two very different way of doing your analytics. One is analyzing an event in real time as it happens. And mm-hmm. the other way is to do a batch analytics. So in HotPath analytics, you are intercepting these events as the events are sort of on the wire mm-hmm. so that you can react and respond to things happening in your ambient environment within a matter of a few seconds.
Wow. Right. Okay, so this isn't about learning about a problem at midnight when the batch runs. This
exactly.
is about learning about it ASAP.
Absolutely. Correct.
Okay, wow. And you've got all these different devices coming from all different places, and the data can come from anywhere.
Data can come from your applications, your devices. We have customers who are managing hundreds and thousands of sensors equipment who and want to understand what is the current status of these machinery and devices. And the way they do it is they send the data to an IoT hub, or if a customer wants to understand the nature of applications that they are running, they send the data to Event Hub. Stream Analytics helps you ingest the data from IoT Hub or Event Hub, and then we do the real-time processing on the data. And we write it to targets like SQL Database, SQL Data Warehouse, Data Lake, you name it, for longer time retention and for you to do batch analytics on it at a later time. Or you can power your real-time dashboards using Push API and Power BI. And we can also help you trigger actions downstream. What happens if you detect an anomaly? What happens when you detect something that is just about to fail? Mm-hmm. You want to trigger an action. You want to maybe create a ServiceNow ticket. Maybe you want to send an email. Maybe you want to send a text alert. And we can help you orchestrate all those kind of things really easy with Azure Stream Analytics.
That's fantastic. And even though we're going to be talking about anomaly detection and some of the new functions and things, this is a great slide that says so much about the power of it. Once you get your data from wherever it's coming into Stream Analytics, the things you can do are just legion.
Absolutely.
Fantastic. Yep. All right. What's next?
So today I'm very happy to announce that we have something known as machine learning-based anomaly detection models in Stream Analytics. Right, so we can help you detect anomalies without really needing for you to write a machine learning algorithm, or you don't have to bring your model. We have models that we have embedded into the code base of Azure Stream Analytics that can be invoked with simple function calls. Right. So, mm-hmm. what are the advantages of this? Many, many advantages. The first one is low cost for you. You don't have to have anomaly detection machine learning scientists who are writing these algorithms, and you don't have to pay for a different machine learning service. All that is just embedded into Azure Stream Analytics. The whole complexity of building your model, training your model, is just abstracted out to a simple function call from Stream Analytics. In addition to that, you can also get things moving faster because you're not writing your model, you're not training it. And there are many advantages because of the paradigm like this.
So how can this be possible, though? Because there's so many different kinds of data, flavors of data. To put it simply, the y-axis is always different depending on what kind of data you're looking at. Data that's in a device like this, whether it be XYZ data or heat or blood sugar information or heart rate, there's so many different kinds of data there. How can you detect an anomaly, you know, and make a machine learning algorithm that works for all flavors of data?
That's a great question. What the model that we have in Stream Analytics for machine learning based anomaly detection, it is an unsupervised learning model. Mm. That means that the model doesn't come with any pre-training. It learns from the data it is starting to read. Mm. So you can tell the model to learn from so many number of events mm-hmm. before it actually starts scoring. As you have said, every system in nature has a different data distribution. So it is very essential that the model comes to you without having any preconceived notion of how the data would look like. It will learn from the data that it is seeing, and then it will start scoring the next set of data points for you.
That makes a lot of sense. That's great to know. But you're still getting me 80% of the way there and saving me lots of time and lots of work that I would have had to do myself.
Exactly. So when we looked at the customers of IoT or Stream Analytics who were using some kind of machine learning algorithms mm-hmm. in their pipeline, it was very evident that about 70% of them were doing some kind of anomaly detection. That's why we decided to make their life really simple by leveraging the richness of Microsoft and Microsoft Research and getting those algorithms embedded into Stream Analytics.
Very cool. All right.
So in Stream Analytics, we are equipped to detect two very broad set of anomalies. One mm-hmm. is the temporary anomalies, mm-hmm. commonly known as spikes and dips, and then persistent anomalies, which are slowly increasing or slowly decreasing sort of trends. If you think about a VM that you might be monitoring in your data center, the memory leak in a VM, it creeps upon you very slowly. Mm-hmm. So those are the kind of anomalies as well that we are equipped to track, not just temporary spikes and dips using the algorithms and the functions that we have.
Now, I had mentioned to you a little bit before, and I'll say it again now, because I'm diabetic and I have a number of IoT devices that help me manage my blood sugar. Both of those things, a temporary anomaly like a high blood sugar from eating food, is something I'd like to know about. Mm-hmm. And I've got all this data in Azure. And a persistent anomaly, has my blood sugar been creeping up on me over the last year and I haven't noticed it? I've been trying to train my own models, but I'd love to be able to do it with Stream Analytics.
Yeah, we should definitely try that.
Fantastic. So you're prepared to do those both. Those are functions that are available to me that I can call?
Exactly.
Okay.
And to your point, this is how simple a function signature to run your anomaly detection algorithm here is. Mm-hmm. So for example, let's take the change point algorithm, which helps you detect the slow trending anomalies. The scalar expression is really the field on which you want to run your anomaly. It could be temperature, it could be pressure, it could be X, Y, Z coordinates, you name it. Mm. It could be a field that is directly coming from your data, or it could be a field that you might have computed in your as a part of your query. Mm-hmm. Confidence level, this is very important because this tells the model, this sets the sensitivity of the model, how sensitive the model should be to certain types of anomalies. The higher the sensitivity, or higher the confidence level, you will see lesser or the number of events or the that will be flagged as anomalies. And lower the confidence level, higher could be the number of anomalies that the model will track for you.
That makes sense. So getting in a car crash is different than going over a speed bump.
Exactly.
Okay.
History size, it is, we follow what we call a sliding window. History size is the number of events you want to pack in that sliding window. And it also indicates to the model how many events to learn from before it actually starts scoring the events in the next window.
Okay.
And then you can use a common Stream Analytics development model, like you can have partition by. This is really important because Let's say you have, in a single query, you are monitoring multiple devices, and each of these devices could have natively different kind of data distribution, and you want a different model to be trained and a different model to be executing on different streams of events that are being managed in the same Stream Analytics query.
Okay.
And that's why when you do the partition by query, you can enable this kind of behavior.
Okay, so then if I wanted to go and find out about potentially change point anomaly detection in my blood sugar over a month, over a year, I can partition these things differently and learn and have them learn separately.
Exactly.
Ah, fantastic.
And duration is the window, not in terms of number of events, but in terms of the time.
Right.
Ideally, the best practice is to have a parity between the history size that we discussed, which is in terms of number of events, and the window size. You can anticipate how many number of events you normally expect to see in that time window,
mm-hmm.
and then you try to strike that parity between the history size and the window size, which is time-based.
Fantastic. This seems hugely powerful.
This is. And when the model runs, when the function runs, you get two different types of output. One is anomaly, which is 0 and 1. 1 indicates that there has been an anomaly that is detected. 0 is there is no anomaly.
Mm-hmm.
And the score. This is a machine learning algorithm. For every event that is being processed, it generates a score. And we are also exposing what the score statistics are for every event that is processed.
Okay. So I've been staring at this device that's been blinking at me. Are you going to show me something cool?
Yeah. So this is a MX chip device that is widely used in the IoT circles. You can buy it online. We also have a SDK for it that you can program using Visual Studio.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And in fact, Microsoft has a SDK for you to develop your cool projects using this MX chip.
Mm-hmm.
And the good thing is MX chip gives you various different types of sensors. It has sensors for temperature, humidity, and what we are going to use today is the accelerometer, which is simply X, Y, and Z coordinates being tracked on this particular sensor.
Right.
And what I have on the screen here is a website from where you can actually leverage the SDK and buy this MX chip toolset.
Okay. So can we see the real data that's coming into this and how it's being analyzed?
Absolutely. So what you have on the screen are three different parameters that are being tracked on Power BI. One is the Z-axis displacement,
mm-hmm.
as tracked by the MX chip. And then down below, we have an anomaly, yes or no.
Mm.
One indicating that there is an anomaly, zero being no anomaly. And then the score associated with every event that the model is processing.
Okay.
So what I will do now is just move this MX chip a little bit in order to disturb the XYZ coordinates. You can assume that this is very similar to a vibration being felt in a turbine, and you may want to slow it down or you may want to stop it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to move it a little bit and rest it back where it is.
Okay.
And within a few seconds, the data gets processed by the Stream Analytics, and you will see that there has been a Z-axis displacement and an anomaly was duly detected using the machine learning algorithm.
And that was only a couple of seconds to have that information figured out.
Exactly.
It's an earthquake. Sorry. I just wanted to see what that would do. So that information takes 1 or 2 seconds. The accelerometer is being sent to Stream Analytics, and then you're going from Stream Analytics into Power BI, and there it is.
Exactly.
So what does that function look like? What's that code look like?
The function is going to be really simple. As you can see, we are getting time and Z-axis from the device.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is where the magic really happens. You have spike and dip algorithm that I'm using.
Mm-hmm.
I'm managing and monitoring the Z-axis. And I'm indicating a 99% confidence level, telling the model that for something to be an anomaly, the model needs to be at least 99% confident. And 500 is the number of events I want that model to learn from,
mm-hmm.
before it starts scoring. And I am suggesting a time window of 120 seconds.
That's pretty
That's
cool.
That's all.
That's all you had to do.
That's all I had to do. And then I'm just going to push my output into a Power BI dashboard.
Mm-hmm. And then when you do your selection there, that's basically projecting that data, and then you use Power BI to get your real-time dashboard.
That's it.
This is the kind of thing I could put together in a fun weekend.
Exactly.
This is fantastic. So where do I go to learn about this information, and how do I get started immediately? Because I love this.
Absolutely. So in order to do that, the documentation for Stream Analytics is really the right place. Mm-hmm. Just go to the documentation, search for anomaly detection, and then all the functions that we have are going to be very well described and defined there for you to use.
This is fantastic. Thank you so much. I am learning all about anomaly detection and some of these great machine learning algorithms that are built into Azure Stream Analytics today on Azure Friday.